Dear colleagues, throughout the last few days, we have received several demands from most of the networks that we belong to, international, to share experience and best practices on the initiatives that at the local level we are developing towards the prevention and the fight against COVID-19. Therefore, I think that the best way to show what we have been doing is to present you all the initiatives that the Municipality of Braga has been developing throughout the last weeks, with a couple of images that show what we have been doing. And we have been acting through and focused in four main areas. The first one was obviously to promote and to impose social restrictions and to avoid contamination and the spread of the virus in our population. The second was to develop a couple of initiatives specifically directed to the health institutions and to the social institutions in our territory. The third one was to provide social responses to individuals that are obviously lacking support because of isolation and because of the lack of resources. And finally, a fourth dimension, which is currently still being mostly developed, which is the economic development. How we have to tackle with the difficulties that are being faced by the local commerce institutions, by many companies, and obviously by workers that will challenge their reality in the near future so that they can avoid unemployment and other difficulties. The first one is obviously how we try to avoid contamination. And I will in Braga separate this in three phases. The first one, which was in the early days of March, was the period in which we cancelled all the public events, like big competitions that we were supposed to host, musical festivals, and all the activities in our cultural and sport venues. We also cancelled all the initiatives and all the programs addressed to the population, cultural initiatives, sports programs, and all the work together with the local institutions. At the same time, we have also closed the access to public equipments like libraries, museums, theaters, the local city forum, and other spaces in which there is usually a big concentration of people. In the second phase, we implemented a more harsh approach. And what we did was to close all local facilities and to send home all of our workers, or at least the biggest majority of them. They are working through teleworking right now or made available to the municipality on a call. The rest, which is a small group, is still working in the local facilities so that we can proceed with all the activities that we need to assure for the functioning of the city. Also, we have restricted the access to public spaces like sports park, kindergartens, and other initiatives and like leisure spaces, so that we could also avoid completely the concentration of people in those spaces. And this was also made not only through a pedagogical approach, but also by creating physical restrictions to the access to these zones. Also, we have cancelled the local fairs and the market in the part which is not connected with food, because we think that it was also necessary to prevent these concentrations. And at the same time, we were also the first city to implement measures to avoid the working of the local commerce, mainly to open their doors to the public. We couldn't close the companies, but we regulated the timetable of their working hours and their opening hours so that they will have what we called the horario zero, that is, no minutes available to open to the public. And therefore, right from the beginning, 3 days in advance from the imposition of the national emergency state, we have clearly restricted the working of most of the commerce in the city at the city center. And finally, in this phase, we have even disconnected the Wi-Fi servers in the public space so that we would also restrict the stimulus for people to go outside to use this public service. At the same time, there were measures imposed in terms of restrictions in the public transportation, and also there was a reinforcement of the cleaning procedures of our environmental company in terms of the cleaning of the public spaces and also the cleaning and the hygienization of the trash bins that are spread all over our territory. And finally, there was the period, the third phase that I'll call, in which the emergency state at national level was imposed, and therefore we have been supporting the security forces through local police patrols to prevent the presence of people in the streets unless for essential reasons. Our second driver was the support to health institutions and social institutions. There is a huge lack in our country of medical equipment and individual kits, and therefore we have been managing a network of donations from companies and individuals that have been very useful to provide to these institutions, to their professionals, all sorts of materials like masks, caps, gloves, shoe covers, and many other instruments that are obviously crucial for their professional development. Also, we have been creating a network of apartments that have been made available for health professionals that don't want to put at risk their families and that don't want to go home after every single day of work. And therefore, we also made available the youth hostel in the city, which is managed by the municipality, so that we could also provide for free the opportunity for those professionals to stay in a safe place throughout this tough phase. Also, at the same time, we have been creating, in partnership with the health administration and a private laboratory, a specific diagnosis center for COVID-19 here in the city. Through this center, we have been able to create an additional 150 tests per day that are being made available to the population, and at the same time, we have created a system that through the support of the municipality, and we were the first city in the whole country to create this solution, we are trying to test every single elderly people that are living in retirement houses, and obviously their professionals that are working for these institutions, so that we can try to isolate the infected people in this very dangerous and very risky group of population. Finally, as the health institutions are trying to avoid the attraction of people to their facilities and are reinforcing their door-to-door services, we have been also providing the borrowing of vehicles from the local city hall to these health institutions so that they can develop their work more easily and more safely also in the city. We are obviously aware that this pandemic reality will have very harsh social consequences. And right from the start, we tried to create some solutions that are mainly addressed to the individuals and obviously to prevent them from the risks that this whole situation can cause. The first one was to create a hotline for help in terms of information for all the citizens that works on a 24 hours per day basis through a call center managed by the municipality, through which either by telephone or by email, any citizen can pose any type of question connected with this reality. We also created a specific hotline for free for elderly people that are isolated and that are prevented from going to the supermarket or through the pharmacy to gather their goods or their medicine. And we have established a partnership with a network of volunteers and local authorities so that we can provide them this distribution by a remote demand, so that through that hotline they can ask us what they need and what type of support they are looking for, and we can provide them at their home with all the safety and with all the care that they need. Finally, we have also created a center for homeless people, which includes a service for bath, for bed, and also for laundry services, apart from the food distribution that is managed by the social security institutions in a partnership also with the Red Cross. And we also created a specific project together with some local NGOs so that we could host the pets from people that are infected and that have been moved to hospitals or to other places, so that these pets are not abandoned throughout this period. On a more financial approach, this period has also forced us to give several exemptions to the commerce, to local entrepreneurs, and even to individuals. Exemptions that are connected with the licensing of a public space, of publicity, of terraces for coffees and restaurants, and also the exemption from our environmental company to the tax on the water treatment and the sewage treatment and the trash collection that has been made for free for the upcoming months. Also, we have reduced the price of water for private individuals so that the increase in the amount of consumption and of water consumption throughout this period wouldn't cause damage to their private budgets throughout this period as well. Also, we haven't been charging the cost for public transportation and for local parking in the cities, because we also think that this is another way to not only to avoid the contamination because of the use of means of payment, but also to reduce the cost for the families throughout this tough period. The upcoming weeks will obviously bring us very difficult challenges in terms of the survival of many of our companies and the sustainability of many of the current jobs that we have in the city. Braga was a very vibrant city in tourism, in commerce, in industry up until today. And obviously we have to deal with all these problems, trying to avoid the difficulties that the companies and the workers will have to face throughout the coming weeks, and obviously to make a quick return to the prosperity that we had before. And taking that into account, immediately we have created a specific consultancy office within Invest Praga, our local economic development agency, that is currently supporting all the entrepreneurs, all the companies in gathering the information that comes from the national measures or the local initiatives, so that we can support it to face this very harsh period. There is also a need to increase the amount of companies that go online, because even if most of those commerce companies have to shut down their opening hours, they can still work on a remote basis, on a takeaway basis, or an online perspective. And we have been developing webinars through Startup Braga and through Invest Braga to help the local entrepreneurs to create their new businesses online through a local platform that we are currently developing. But at the same time, we are also conscious that most of the solutions for these difficulties will have to come from national policies or by European policies at the European Union level. And therefore, we are working with our economic ambassadors, with the local commerce institutions, with the many movements of entrepreneurs that have been recently created, to gather all their concerns, all their suggestions, all their proposals, and to evaluate those proposals together with the teachers and other academic people from the universities, so that we can build a common program to present to these institutions and to obviously ask for its implementation in the near future. It's obviously a very complicated period to all of us mayors, and I think that like in many, many cases, the local authorities will still be the lighthouses in facing with this problem, will be the source of innovation in the solutions in many of the domains that this pandemic really gathers. And therefore, I'd like to send a warm message of support to all the mayors, to all the local authorities that worldwide are being challenged by this reality, but are obviously in the first line of response to the concerns of their populations. Good luck, everyone, and please be strong. We'll meet soon.